What's going on, people? Welcome to United View. Welcome to my reflection video after our game against Bayern Munich. I've just finished up here at 5, just done our show on a take on me, Anton, Danny Murphy's gone.
Is it a deflection show or a reflection?
You see what they're on?
What one is it, Flex?
Well, I don't deflect. I face things head on, as you can see. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Which you said it even in the show. You're like, right, you're saying that you're going to lose there. Yeah, I'm being real. I don't deflect. I just reflect. Yeah, okay. On what's happened. So it's not a deflection. Just with what's been going on today, obviously, look, we're out of the Champions League now. You know, there's reports that it's going to cost Man United the best part of £28 million. This is from James Ducker, The Telegraph, saying it's going to cost Man United £28 million and pile pressure on Ten Hag. And I actually, just on the game last night, before I move on in my reflection, I'm like, we just didn't lay a glove on Bayern Munich. And large parts of the game plan was all right, but not only did we not lay a glove, I just saw like the massive gulf in quality, which I knew already, but just with it, how evident it was in the moment.
Do you think, Flex, that Ten Hag's comments after the game, we played well?
Don't help himself, man.
Doesn't help him. So is that him tapping out? Is he like that him tapping out?
I was going to get on to that. I'm glad you asked that. Because it's true. Like, this is the thing as well of like, a lot of us back in Ten Hag, right? I can't speak for all of you because it is becoming more polarizing as a topic. It is becoming more of a situation where you start to get, are you Ten Hag in, Ten Hag out? It always happens with every manager at some point at Man United. And like, one thing I have noticed is what he's saying in the press conferences and some of the decisions he's making, aside from the football club and all the things that are wrong with it and stuff, there's things at his doorstep that you can't shake off. Whether that's the Varane situation, he ain't played since like October, not started a game. Then all of a sudden we play a big team, he like needs to play, he's a quality defender.
And he played well.
You play him left centre back with Harry Maguire when he was adamant tactically that he can't do that. That's why I didn't even though it was Bayern Munich before the game, bro, I was like, when I was doing like my predicted lineup, I was like, yeah, but Varane ain't going to play. Because he ain't been playing, it's going to be Johnny Evans or Victor Lindelof. Our manager told us that. Then he just brings him in. That shows me it's like a little bit of a desperation. You obviously haven't played. You speak about it a lot. It's like, if you've been out of favour or you've seen how you've been treated, and look, he's a top pro. He's won everything there is to win. But you left him out for enough times and then all of a sudden you're going, I need you. And I know as a pro, you always have to be ready. Same with Harry Maguire. He was left out all last season. He's been ready. He's got to be ready. And he came in and played well. It proves he's a pro. Yeah. But these are the little bit of discontent. You know, some of the decisions that he's made tactically and substitutions-wise. And then, like you said, in the presses afterwards, like, I know you can't, he's obviously got to a point where he can't cuss these players out all the time in public. You know, he ain't getting a response out of them, so he's trying to mollycoddle them in public, but don't say we played well. Rah. Don't say we played well.
I think that's almost, from my opinion, I think that's almost disrespectful to the fan base because, son, I've been going to United for years, obviously watching Rio playing there. And to have one shot on target at home and the manager say you played well, it's almost like it's don't add up.
It's like borderline delusion, isn't it? Because it's like you can still criticise us and the players and they have to expect it without throwing them under the bus. But that kind of false toxic positivity don't help. That doesn't make the fan base feel calm. We want to see somebody who's quite aggressive and methodical and really open and honest about how we've played in it, and it doesn't.
It almost sounds like he's just happy you didn't get walloped. Do you know what I mean? It almost just sounds like that. We played well because we didn't get walloped against a really, really good Bayern team with that attacking prowess. You know what I mean? So that to me is, and that's what I'm asking, do you think he's tapped out?
I don't think he's tapped out. I think he's still trying, but it's becoming more and more evident with each passing game just how little he can get out of this current set, which he's contributed to with some signings. You know, I'm not going to shy away from Onana, Anthony. Amrabat's done okay in recent games, but not, you know, hasn't lit it up. Mount's been injured, hasn't got going yet. Rasmus Højlund, like, that's another thing. I was looking at Rasmus Højlund yesterday, right? And I had this sort of...
Anthony is what? One assist in how many games?
I don't even know.
No goals and one assist in how many games, yeah? That is a madness, man. That is like... And I don't want to keep bringing it up.
Yeah.
But Sancho's stats ain't like that.
No, and he would have, but again, I know you don't keep bringing it up, but like, bro, I have to keep stating this. The reason why he's not playing, bro, is not because he thinks that just Anthony's better than him and Sancho's not good enough to play for Man United. The reason why he's not playing is all the things that is for a whole nother video.
But it's his fault. Yeah, but just to summarize.
But he's not. You're right. Anthony's no better. I don't want Anthony to keep playing it.
And I agree. Sancho's fault for not playing. I get that.
Mm.
I've always said, and my thing with Ten Hag is consistency.
Mm.
You know, if you're going to, you can't all of a sudden go for one player, I'm going to hammer you in the press, and then another player, then all of a sudden go, I'll deal with it in-house.
Mm.
When let's have it right, when you look at both, and I'm talking Sancho and Rashford, right? Sancho came out and defended his honour because Ten Hag publicly said about him his work ethic in training, and then went to America stupidly and was pictured in a nightclub stupidly, yeah? Then Rashford, you look at Rashford, played in a derby, was terrible, went out that night for his birthday with a midweek game pending, by the way, yeah? Didn't play that game because he went out and it was noted that he went out. Then played the weekend, was rubbish. Then fast forward to a Newcastle game a week later or in the league a week later or 2 weeks later and showed one of the worst displays of work ethic I've ever seen.
Awful. And we keep getting that big disparity between performances.
But that's why I always bring it up in terms of like there needs to be consistency because, okay, Sancho's not training and not been training well. That's what they're saying. But then Marcus Rashford can't be training well because he's work ethic in the game.
But that's the thing is that Eric, we have to take it as face value. Eric believes that he's doing enough to make the match day squad, but he's just not doing his job in the games. Sancho's one was, you were that bad in training, you can't even make the match day squad. That's it. I think a manager should be able to say that. I'm not disputing that,
but why not look it in a way of, okay, you've come out and backed your honour, show me.
Mm.
Show me.
Mm. I'm
going to give you time, show me.
But he hasn't said sorry, so he can't.
But again,
you can't do that. Let's not, because I'm going to get back.
Sorry.
You're going to get me angry again.
Sorry.
And I've actually been really good the last couple of games to not get angry. Rio said yesterday that it's the best out of a bad situation, bad scenario for Man United to just go out of everything altogether. I didn't want to be in the Europa League. Mm-hmm. You know, even going into this thinking that we're not going to get out of the Champions League, which I knew we wasn't, didn't want to end. All that's going to happen in Europa League is, you know, PSG drop down into it or Newcastle or whoever it is. Yeah. Liverpool already in there. We'll just get more licks at some point. West Ham and get licks as well. Oh, you're in it as well, innit? That ain't going to happen, but yeah, you'll probably be out next round. But I just weren't on it. I'm like, we just need to be out of everything and just this whole change needs to come because I'm just sick of it. The whole thing just needs scrapping.
I get what Rio's saying. However, for Ten Hag, the pressure is really on now because there's no out.
There's nowhere to hide now.
The results in the league are paramount now. Like, let's have it right. You ain't got that, oh, we've got a midweek game where we're in Europe and we need to win. We're trying to win silverware. So we're going to concentrate on that. No. You need to try and get into a place where you're in a Champions League again.
Mm.
Or in Europe, even, we would say.
But it's true. Like, we spent all last year trying to get into the Champions League. To just do what we did. We've conceded like the most goals out of an English side ever in the Champions League. You know how mad that is?
And finished
rock bottom of a group that Man United should comfortably become
the record.
We're breaking all kinds of records.
For the wrong reasons. Yeah,
or the 7-0 at Liverpool. Like, it's just like the 6-4 at Etihad, whatever it is. Just licks.
Yeah.
Like, this is just what it is, man. But my biggest takeaway from yesterday to finish off was that obviously, we're way off the levels of Bayern. They were going through the motions, training session settings. Harry Kane was just dropping off the front. Kingsley Coman and Sané were going around him. Musiala on the half turn. Like, just couldn't compete. But actually, for little bits, we looked all right, like in terms of our shape and stuff.
Yeah.
But you have to question Bayern's intensity. And then I just saw the golfing class of just Mané just not good enough, bro. Like, they're just not.
Have you seen Leroy Sané's post on social media.
What did he say? Harry at AV was there, was still talking to getting a shirt signed and that as well.
He added Rio in it because there's a picture of Rio talking to Harry Kane.
Yeah.
Rio's got a bubble saying, why didn't we sign Harry? And Harry's saying something. And then Leroy Sane's there just laughing. And he posted it.
Banner. Bro, the German fan, the Bayern Munich fans, yeah?
They were singing,
football's coming home. They're singing to us, you're shitting, you know you are. And they're singing to us, is this a library?
Wow.
Perfect English accents as well. Do you know what?
That is damning to hear, is this a library at Old Trafford?
Yeah, because it is now.
Trafford, the fear of dreams. On a Champions League night.
We have to be real. That's what we are now, bro. That's what we are. So.
Wow.
Anyway, guys, that's the reflection. Let us know how you're feeling. There has been a little bit of talk about Manchester United's preferred managers list and stuff like that. Things are starting to come out. Julian Lopetegui's name has been mentioned as someone that Man United like. Zinedine Zidane, Graham Potter. And look, I'm not even going to go too much into that because I don't think it's there yet. But guys, like we said, with all kind of seatbelts or however you strap yourself in, whether it's the Alton Towers nemesis thing where you pull it down and it clicks in, bro. If it's the fighter jet thing where you've got the double strap there, whether it's the seatbelt like that, whatever it is you need to do to get through this week as a Man United fan, do it. Because if you didn't do it from yesterday's game, Anfield's coming. We're out of here. Take care. Peace.